quick introduction to the session that's going on. You can hear me, right? Everything's audible, right?
Yes, it's audible.
Okay, fantastic. So everyone here that's joined, Akshay is the co-founder of this company called Merge Intern, Merge. And you can check them out. It's mergeintern.com. So, and Akshay has helped a lot of people. So basically, it's pretty clear, even if you just go on the website, you'll pretty much understand. They help you with, you know, the right kind of skills that help you crack internships. They have a lot of workshops that occur in various subjects like web development, data structures, and interestingly also on, you know, how to amp up your CVs, your resumes, and you know, boost your skills, use your LinkedIn properly, and how you can best optimize your LinkedIn and your personal brand. So yeah, over to you, Akshay. Before you start, like, just a quick intro from your end too on what you are going to be covering today. And for everyone here, we're using conference room 2 just so that, you know, the speaker maintains the flow of the conversation. But if you have any doubts, if you have any questions and want to interact with them, just please use the main text channel. So the main channel, hashtag main, and you can ask your questions. Over to you, Akshay.
So hello, everyone.
Yeah, they won't be able to respond, okay? They'll only be responding through text.
Sure.
On mail, okay? Yeah.
So I'll be covering a couple of topics today. One would be on LinkedIn. So how do you showcase yourself online? Then comes, what is it that you have to do to get real world exposure? And apart from that, also would be covering how is that you could get a career in web development too. So I'm Akshay. I'm the co-founder at Merge Intern. Previously, I had an IT services company called AVM Labs, where we helped businesses digitize by building their websites, mobile apps, e-commerce solutions. And apart from that, I have been a mentor and I've trained more than 4,000 engineering students on emerging technologies like data science, machine learning, web development. So Merge is a skill-based assessment platform for companies to hire tech talent. So on our platform, we help companies hire interns. So for the students here, if you want to get internships, feel free to go to our platform Merge Intern, take an assessment over there. So after you clear the assessment, you'll be able to apply for internships. And all of these internships give you amazing stipends. Let it be. Okay, so all of you guys, I believe you'll be responding in the main channel, right? So I'll be asking certain questions. Feel free to answer them. So one is, which social media platforms do you use the most? This would help me understand most of the things, what you guys are doing. Okay, Discord, Instagram, LinkedIn, Instagram, LinkedIn. Okay. Started with using Twitter and LinkedIn recently. That's amazing. Okay. So why do you think LinkedIn is necessary? Since so many other platforms are there, right? So why do you think that you should be on LinkedIn? Okay, professional network. That's amazing. Right. So most of the professionals are on LinkedIn. Now, in this 21st century, resumes do not carry most value. How are you online? That is what matters the most, right? So you need to know, how do you showcase your talent, what you have, to the outer world? It may be by creating blogs, by creating content on what you're doing, whatever that might be. So there's a quote that says that HRs mostly search a name on Google, and whatever comes there is your personal brand. every one of you have your brand on your own. So it totally depends on how good or how bad you make your brand value. There are certain ways in which you can may make your brand. For example, let's say all of you would have heard about Elon Musk, Sundar Pichai, or Gary Minati, right? So how did you get to know about these people? News using their social media profiles. If I would say that if you know the co-founders of Infosys, most of you would say, I know Narayan Murthy, but there are 7 other co-founders of Infosys, right? So it totally depends on how good you build your brand on social media. There are certain other factors as well, which would determine that. So one is you would showcase what you know to the outer world, right? So there are like more than 1 billion people there on LinkedIn, right? HRs do not have so much of time to come check your profile there. And next thing is most of the jobs that are there available right now happen through referral network. How would you build a credibility among the people working in a company to refer you is that you need to showcase your talent on social media. For example, let's say if there's a person working in Google, you cannot directly go to him and ask that, I know Python, can you refer me to a job which requires Python. This would not be possible by him, right? So you have to build that credibility there on the social media platform that you know this particular language. It might be everyone has a unique way to showcase your skills. Might be through posts, might be through blogs, might be through codes, but whatever that might be, your unique way. So, but you have to be consistent enough. Just by posting once in a month would not build that credibility, right? So you have to be present always there online. Because every day a recruiter comes to their profile and they see a post of yours, they know that there's a person called XYZ available there. So whenever they have an opening in their company, definitely your name would come up there. But there are certain things that you need to follow there on LinkedIn. One is have a professional profile picture. Okay, so do not use a casual profile picture which you use on Facebook or Instagram. This would not give a good feeling to a recruiter, right? So may have a good professional profile picture. Then comes your bio. Have a well curated bio. Do not just mention that I'm looking for opportunities, right? So it would not make sense to any recruiter. Say that, let's say you are a Python developer, you've been working on these projects, and you're looking for a role in this opportunity. Be very clear in that. Do not update using unprofessional content or information or various pictures there. Only have good, useful content and create a very niche set for you. Let's say if you are a web developer, only post about web development. Make sure that your audience know that you are a web developer. Don't just post one day about web development, one day about app development, another day about social media marketing. Your audience would be biased about you, right? They would not know what you're focused on. They do not know where your expertise lies, right? So you need to know what is your audience, what is it that your career goal is, and focus on that. So whenever a person has this, let's say if a person wants a web developer, definitely they would be looking at you. There are certain ways, because I get a lot of requests every day on just people messaging me saying that I want an internship opportunity. I want a job. Can you help me? Right? No one has this patience to go check your profile, check what you do, where your expertise lie, check or projects what you do, and then refer you. These things, people do not have so much of time to do all these things. So first is you have to give an introduction about yourself when you're pitching yourself to someone. So tell what you do, what are your projects that you have done, what is your expertise in, and then start pitching about that. You're looking for a role in that company because your vision lies with that, and then reply him. Because usually there's a lot of huge gap between HRs and the students or the candidates who are looking for jobs. It's very difficult to find talent nowadays. People want quality rather than quantity, right? So you have to be very precise, very sure on what you're looking. It is very easy to crack jobs. So as a student, I would recommend you to start an internship. Be very early, start an internship. You would get introduced to this professional world on what you have to do, how are the things that you have to understand. So for example, let's say usually companies do not recruit freshers. To give a small example, so a company, if they call a fresher to a meeting, he would just not randomly answer to that call. Or these are the bit of professional ethics usually freshers do not follow in this corporate world. So that is why majorly, if you see most of the openings, they require 1+ years of experience because they would at least have gone one year of training, right? So have a good professional ethics and you would get introduced to this professional world if you are doing an internship. Most of the students also do not know what to do in their career, right? So you would have an understanding that if you do this internship and after you complete this, while you're doing that, you will get to know that these are the job roles. So this is what I would have to do if I work in this career. And you would be able to decide on what career that you want to do in, because you're studying like 4 years of engineering and you would not know what to do later on, right? So it would make no sense. So when you start an internship, you start to develop new skills because you would be working on many projects and that would require you to develop new skills. So you'd be confined for that. So these are the things that would help you to work on, as well as it would give a boost to your profile, to your portfolio, that you have done an internship on this field, you've worked on this project, and you've scaled the project from, let's say, X users to XYZ users. So these are the bit of numbers that would help you. I've seen certain students where they go to an upskilling portal and they pay money to get an internship certificate. This is not an internship. This is an upskilling course that you're doing, right? Do not mix that with an internship. Okay. So will anyone hire a BCom guy? If yes, then how? So I would not recommend, like, we as a recruiter also, I've hired more than 100 folks previously. So we do not much see on the educational terms. We only see whether are you capable to solve the company's problem or not. How is that possible? Let's say a company's website is not good. So that means that they are looking for a good web developer. If you are a web developer, make a short landing page for that company and then send it to the founder, mail it to him. So this is a good pitch that you are a web developer, you're proving your skills and you are ready to be hired. So I've seen most of the students are able to crack this without even getting an interview call. First, see whether you are able to solve a company's problem, then start applying for that company. Tell them that what is it that they're facing? How can you help them by joining that company? If you're able to do these things, then definitely you will be hired. Okay. So how many of you know web development or are interested in a career in web development? Yes or no? So this is what I would suggest most of the students to do. I would recommend them not to go into data science or machine learning initially. First, learn web development. Companies who need machine learning engineers or data scientists are those who have millions of data, right? So if they have millions of data, that means that they would definitely be generating millions of dollars in revenue. So they would be hiring experienced professionals. So they would not be giving their data to freshers. It's only that these big MNCs would be hiring freshers, but the rate at which they're hiring is very low. So every company, every product that a company is building needs a web developers. That means that every company has a web developer opening. First, get into a web developer job or get into a job first. Then start looking out for different other positions. It is easier to switch in a company rather than to apply for a new company for a role. Web development is the one of the fastest growing jobs. So I would recommend you, even if you're a web developer or not a web developer, have a good portfolio website. How do you do a portfolio website? One is by hard coding it. If you're a web developer, it would really help you. So it would boost your resume. Next is, if you're not a web developer, if you're focused on digital marketing or UI UX, product management, then you can easily build a website by using no-code tools. Wix is there. There is Webflow. There are many tools. Every company first is they look at your website. They do not want to see your resume. And if they are seeing your resume, that means that they only give less than 6 seconds of time to view your resume. So ensure that you have a really good portfolio. Because you build that credibility or trust among that recruiter that you know these things, and that is why you're applying for a certain company. So there are several reasons why students usually do not get replies from company, let's say for internship or for fresher job roles. One is mainly that students do not know for what role they are applying for. They do not know what they have to do after coming there, because recently we posted that we are hiring business development managers. We got a lot of requests. We got over 250 requests. Okay. So in the first 30 people we interviewed, 25 people did not know that why they applied. They just saw that there was a role there. That is why they applied. So this is like one of the major reasons why students do not get replies from recruiters. It might be that you have correctly replied, but most of them do not know what they are doing there. So if you are doing this, that it would be very difficult for you to get a reply from the recruiter and then get selected. Have a tailor-made resume or a portfolio for every company you apply for. Your resume will stand out there. Okay. So I'll just start answering the questions in a couple of minutes. Yes. Meanwhile, you can start posting the questions if you have any. So. I will share a couple of sample portfolios in the channel. Give me a couple of minutes. And so do not worry about the IT services companies who build websites for people. So if you see that if you just go search on LinkedIn, every month there are 50,000 openings in web development only across the globe. So you have a lot of chances in getting a job in web development. And majorly these tech companies do not outsource it. It is these businesses who majorly outsource it to these companies. How do we build that credibility? So to give you an example, if you see that there are many people out there on LinkedIn who post daily. Why do they do that? Do you think that they get any income from that? No, they don't. Might be that they get opportunities from that. That is indirect way of getting money. They build a good network with various other professionals. This is really important to succeed in life. Second is, if you even if you have joined a company, it is easier for you to grow higher the ladder if you start building an online brand, because your name would be published to the higher position people. And apart from that too, if you are a student, many people recognize you and then give you opportunities. See, most of the founders or most of the people who look forward to create synergies are always online on LinkedIn. So if you are looking forward for an opportunity, I would recommend you to stay consistent. Post one post a day, might be anything, whatever you read that day, post about it. And post about the topic in which you are looking for a career on, so that people also know that you are a web developer and they would definitely give you opportunities. What if I have more than one passion and I would like to optimize my LinkedIn for all the things? So it is really difficult to do this. But first is focus on one and then expand it to the another. First is, if your main passion is in web development, focus on web development, build a credibility, build an audience who is looking forward for web developers, build that, and then it would be easier for you to focus on other things. What exactly do I post on LinkedIn as I work as a freelance video editor? Post about the videos you do, right? This is the content which you have. So people get to know that you're a really good video editor. They get to know what kind of videos you edit. For example, it might be 2D videos, 3D animations, anything for that matter, right? So there is a lack of video editors in the market, right? So there are lots of opportunities available. I'm struggling to get freelance digital marketing projects. How can I get one? Any suggestions? Okay. So every company needs a digital marketer. You should always remember this. Sometimes the founders would know digital marketing because everyone has, every company or every product needs to build their online brand presence. How do you do that? How do you convince a company to hire you as a freelance digital marketer? Is first show your results, show what you have done till date. Let's say you work for a company, you need not specify that company name. Tell them that this company spent this much amount and I was able to get them this much result. This is your credibility that you're building among the audience. Skills you need in your respective field that you came. Okay. Any suggestions for investment course? What kind of investment stock or what is it? If you could specify that, that'll be easier. Should we make brand of our name or some name I like? I would recommend you to make a brand of your name first, because people do not know you. If people already know you, then you can make another brand name. Mr. AJ, any courses you recommend to do in college years and where from? All the courses are already available in YouTube. So that is why we do not have any big courses there on Merge Intern. So we have this course called Career Kickstarter Bootcamp, which we do for 7 days, right? So first is we enable you to start learning web development. And we also have another course called Data Structures Algorithms, which we help for final year students or freshers who are looking for jobs or internships. So why do we do that? Is students do not know how to search and where to search. All the content is available online, but students do not know where do I go first to start, get started. So this is what we do. And at Merge Intern as well, we have a mentor network consisting of SDs from Jaguar, Land Rover, Paytm, Google, Microsoft, many companies. So all of these help the students. Okay, Renuka, I really appreciate you for that question. So even I did not know in my first year of education on what to do. I did not know what were the fields that were there as well. So how I started to do is I first learned app development, and then I started to do a project in there. So there I got to know how the field and where would companies hire. So that is when I started to understand the business value for that. Then I started to learn web development parallelly, because I did not know that which one would I like, web development or app development. So when I learned web development, then I came across this field called data science and machine learning. I thought like this is a good idea because I like maths. So when I put my hands in data science and machine learning, that became very interesting. But then later I got to know that the opportunities in this field is very limited. So why not I continue having a good portfolio in web development? So I put my hands in every single thing, because if you are a student, you have a lot of time. Like you go to college from morning to afternoon, and after that you have entire time free, right? So at least if you put like 1 hour or 2 hours a day in learning a new skill, that would really help you to understand where you're good at and where should you pursue your career. What to post on LinkedIn? How do I post? Okay, so what should you post? Let's say you read a blog on this and this thing. So let's say you're a web developer. There's a new framework that's coming up or a new library that's coming up. You read a blog on that. Make a good content over that and post it on LinkedIn. Everyone makes mistakes, right? You would not be perfect in the first thing. And next thing, do not think that what would others think about you. Never have that attitude, because everyone started from zero. Never be an introvert. You should remove that. That would really be a huge obstacle for you later on in your career. Many people are posting similar content regarding marketing and business news and case study. So how would it differentiate our content? So very good question. So to answer this, everyone, like, content is available already there, right? There's so many news media, everything is there. But why do you think that every news media has its own viewers? Because everyone posts uniquely. So you should also remember that. Everyone has a unique style of representation. You would have a unique way to tell content, and some other person would have a unique way to share his content. So you have to know how would your viewers like it, because let's say after posting for a month, there'd be certain set of viewers who'd be looking forward to see your post regularly. Everyone would know how you would post it, so they would be eagerly waiting for your post to come up on that particular content. So never matter whether your project is bad or good. Never think on that. Just start posting it, because you get good feedback. You get criticism, everything. So you need to understand how would you take that as well. So when you start posting it, people will be like, hey, this is already copied from somewhere else. Do not post it. But do not worry on those things. You get criticism everywhere. It totally depends on how would you take that and then use that to upskill yourself, or use that to... You don't have to much take it. So rather just leave that as it is. And then people who always, there are always people who want to bring you down, right? So do not worry on that. Just focus on yourself. Start posting content. Content is the king now. So yes, this do happens that sometimes you do not get content always. Let's say you want to post today and you do not have anything in your mind. So what you can do is have a book. So whenever you get something on your mind, make sure that you make a note of it so that you would never be out of content. I would give like a challenge to all of you. Take this, start posting content daily for 50 days. You will see a lot of improvement yourself, because for to post a content every day, you would spend some time to look onto what is new every day, right? You would start researching many things which you would not be doing right now. So focus on these things, you would be really better than what you were. There is no ideal profile for any person. It is how unique you represent yourself online. So first is you mention what are the things you do. Good, have a good bio, have a good about section. Mention the internships or projects which you have done. If you're going for a marketing profile, mention about the campus ambassadors. So mention what is relevant basically to a recruiter or basically for your career. I've seen that students applying for a tech job mention majorly about the campus ambassador role or the marketing role which they have done. It is not at all required by the company, right? So they do not require a marketer who does web development. They require a web developer who has done some work on it. So mention what is actually required by the company. So you should understand what the company is into and then focus on that. Share my LinkedIn profile. Worry on making number of connections rather than making a good number of network online. I see that some of the students whom I interact with, they have never done a resume also. Just by how they have built their good online presence and credibility, that is how they have got a lot of opportunities. And so when you get stuck at some of the points, for example, let's say you get into these MNCs, mass hiring companies, you do not know what to do there because your job is very limited. You're part of big operation there, right? So you do not know what to study online and how would your career be. Focus on building good products. Work with various other startups. You would learn various things there. And when you're a student, get a mentor. Talk to people, say them that you're stuck in this thing, get a mentor. If you are really genuine, they would definitely mentor you. Because value your other people time as well. Okay, so if you want me to share any insights about your LinkedIn, feel free to share it. You can connect to me on Twitter here. Okay. Give me a second. I'll just answer a couple of questions previously. Okay, for web development internships, should I start looking for internships with just HTML and CSS or wait till I am comfortable with JavaScript and React? Most of the companies who hire web developers majorly look for React, Angular, or Vue. Make sure that you're very good at these things. Start building 5 projects. Keep this as a benchmark and then apply to company. No one will reject you there. Because if you start getting limited to HTML and CSS, the companies which look forward for them would also be very limited. Majorly mentioned about what all you have done, but if you see in your profile, it would be very difficult to understand whether you're a developer or you like managing community. Let's say if you want to be a campus ambassador or if you want to manage campus ambassadors. So mention what you're really good at and you're not very clear on your profile. Mentioned couple of projects which you have done that is really good, and also you have put that you're a brand image designer, video editor, graphic design instructor. That's really good. Have a good about section. Your about is very limited, so have about and mention the links to your portfolio as well. That would really help people who are looking forward to work with you. How do I find foreign clients for web projects on LinkedIn? Is there high competition for the same position? There's nothing like high competition. If a client feels that your projects are enough, or if they feel that you're really good or credible, so they definitely come to you. But to build that credibility, you have to really be strong in online. You have to be very consistent, because if you're not posting it, let's say for a week, people will forget about you. Your bio should be a bit long. So I guess there are about 100 characters. Make sure that you fill all of them. Don't leave it empty. And in your about section, it's good, but you have not mentioned that how can a person contact you. Add a couple of more experience, whatever you have done, and mention numbers there. What have you achieved till date? So right now I don't have any passion, but different interest. It's okay to keep posting on whatever you like initially. So once you understand what you have to post on, then you can start picking up a niche topic and then start posting only on that. No college teaches React, JS, Angular, so don't worry on that. You need to research on what is actually required by people, so focus on that. So Bill Gates has just told that, right? So to be successful, you need to do what the world requires. And to be even more successful, your passion should lie along with it. Always remember this. Missing questions. Sorry for that. So you can repost it if I have missed any. Any queries or anything, feel free to DM me on LinkedIn. So, Saurabh. You have a very good profile on LinkedIn. So just mention in your about section, how can a person contact you and how would you be helping with them? So it's just only that is missing. So if you add that, that will be really helpful. Okay, so how do you find mentors? This is really hard for anyone. So not everyone can become your mentor, right? So you have to identify that one person who has really helped you or whom you think that could add value to your profile or to your career. So make sure that you also give the same to them on what they are looking for. It is definitely mutual, right? Because they're giving you time. So you have to also value their time. So if you're doing that, definitely you'll be getting amazing mentors. So don't straight away start looking for mentors, start networking, start talking to people. You have to come outside the shell, start talking to people. That is when you find really good mentors. So any guidance or tips? I'm an engineering student studying in sixth semester. So there's nothing like tips as such. So focus on one thing, do one thing at a time. Don't put too many things on the plate. I've seen most of the students working with 4 or 5 companies, but they're not able to achieve anything in any company. So don't do that. This is what I would recommend to most of the students. Focus on one company, work with a company. If there is no stipend, if you see that you're getting any value, that's okay. Work with that company, you will get a lot of things. Just be taking 2 more questions. So entrepreneur and have something on my own, I need to impact a lot. So to be an entrepreneur, I would recommend this. Don't focus on the idea. Everyone has amazing ideas, but at the end, it only depends on how better you do the operations part. How better do you execute it? Do not focus on building a company. First, focus on building a product and then scaling it up to a company. Start working with products. Start building them. When you start building them, you also go talk to people. That is when you build a good network. And you need to know how to sell a product. This is really important if you want to be an entrepreneur. Sales is really important. Okay, how do we start a conversation and build good relationship if you're a newbie on LinkedIn? So connect with five people whom you think are really good at that. So message them, hey, I'm this, I'm really good at this and this. So you can, I've done projects on these. I'm stuck at this. Can you help me at this? Figure out what I have to do. And then tell that if there is any relevant opportunity, could you please help me figure out that? Or could you help me by mentoring me? Or can you check and then give feedback on my projects? So you have to ensure that you get a reply from them. So never be some question that, hey, can I get an internship? Hey, can you give feedback on my project? First, tell about yourself and then tell what you're looking for. This is really important. How do I bring investors and make sure that they invest? This is really a different topic, so we can have another day on that. Okay, so I'll just share my profile again in case you want to connect to me. Feel free to connect to me here. So there are some people who might not refer you. Why would they not refer you is because you might not have built that credibility with that person. So ensure that you first build a credibility, because giving a referral for them also, it's a stake on them, right? They are referring them. That means that they also should know how you are. Before knowing how you are, nobody will refer you. So ensure that you do these things there. Credibility. So to build credibility, it takes time to build that. So you have to be very consistent, keen on posting content online. So it depends where your audience, target audience is. So if you want to build a good credibility among professionals, LinkedIn is an amazing place. And start sharing what you have done till now and then ask. Don't just ask people randomly. Nobody is going to give their time easily. So first is make sure that you start sharing what all things you have done and then start asking. This is really going to help everyone. So I'll be winding up with this. Thank you guys. Feel free to connect to me. And if you have any queries in future, you can always DM me either on Twitter or on LinkedIn. Thank you guys.